Chingu, I'm here again to update you on my home quarantine because I've been diagnosed. I was diagnosed with having COVID-19 and pneumonia, both lungs. So I hope that this vlog will help you. Bye, chingu. Yes, please subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell. Good afternoon, chinguuuuyas. I know it's been chingu been having long time not uploading my videos due to a lot of things happened to me. If I'm ready to open up, supposedly I'm going to post a video that happened to me last October, but I was not prepared to share it because of personal things, and now it's really a tough time with me to share with you guys. Supposedly I would want to upload photos, which is really like funny and stuff, but things on my way is not like that. And I wanted to share it to you guys because maybe there is persons, chingu, na also with the same situation that I'm into. And it's really hard nowadays. I had before 2 RT-PCR and it's both negative. But now, it's a different story. It's positive. And I hope, chinguuuuyas, this video would help you and strengthen your faith. I don't wanna weep, guys. Sorry. But my vlog for today is about the facts about Omicron. Omicron, and of course the difference of Omicron and Delta variant COVID. Because all you know is that I'm always into health vlogs, right? And now I will share to you my quarantine story, and this is my day 5. I've had my swab January 12. So okay, guys. So I will tell you first my story about my quarantine days. Last January 4, we had an antigen because of my daughter had fever for almost 2 days, and my son have episodes of sneezing, colds. So we got tested, and I'm the only one who's negative. Since that day, I was really anxious, and in the same time, you know, I wanted to strengthen myself. Because, you know, they needed me the most of that moment. I was the runner. I was the one, you know, buying medications, all the needs at the home. And I am the one going out, you know, cooking for them, taking good care of them. Most especially on my daughter, Catriona, because she was the one. It was really not okay that time. She had really like continuous fever, and she have the symptoms, cough, colds, you know, fever. Luckily, my son only have minor symptoms, cough and colds, but he haven't been had fever. MJ had fever as well, headache, body pains that he's complaining of, like having flu. So I was really like praying hard not to get the virus, you know, the whatever variant it is. But there are times that, you know, like I don't have sleep, you know, it's a sleepless nights. Cause every time my daughter cough, I'm always checking her out, so I don't have enough rest and sleep. So my mom also been tested that time, but my mom decided to go home knowing that she's positive as well. So I'm always also thinking of it, you know, every time, because she's not around and she's alone in Bulacan. So she's had her home quarantine there. Luckily, she's gone okay after this. So it's really like every time I had this symptoms, I had sneezing and also colds and coughing, thinking that maybe it's just, you know, lack of sleep. And I also have rhinitis, so I know that it's rhinitis because January 4, I also have, like, that feeling, you know. But it got getting really kind of worse, you know, as days goes by. So, so until now, I have, like, this kind of episode, like, a dry cough. So, I thought I'm finally okay, like, I'll be having, returning to work because of January 4, thinking that I'm negative until January 7, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. No, it's 8 because I'd love to returning to work, I mean. So, it's like, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, yeah, it's 10. Sorry, it's 10. And then, but on the 8th, January 8th, there's something that's been bothering me because I felt weird that I wasn't able to sleep, you know, and I have like an upper back pain. Yes, upper back pain. And then, I thought that it's just because I'm sleeping, in a wrong, like a foam, like a piece of foam, you know, but it continuously had, and I had shortness of breathing. So, we had an antigen again with my brother-in-law because I'm hoping to return on the 12th. I'm hoping to return to work at January 12th. And I had an antigen and I'm negative, hoping, but I'm positive. After 15 minutes, we were taking the antigen. I'm positive with this bright two reds. I'll maybe show the pictures at the end, you know, of my vlog. And it's really like, I don't know, it's like mixed emotion that time. I'm trying to be, you know, composed, but it's really hard. And my daughter Kat still have it, and my husband, like a trace. But the one thing that's been so made me relieved that my son is already negative. So I went to the emergency room January 12th because it's really like persistent having shortness of breathing, and like at night time I cannot sleep, like I have difficulty of breathing. And I need two pillows to be able to sleep. And every time that, you know, I have this fetal position at the side, I cannot breathe well. So I need to, like, have a semi-fowler, like, you say, 90 degrees. Like, just straight. And then two pillows to be able to sleep. So that January 12th, I talked to my friend asking for advice. But because she's been positive and she's a nurse as well, you know, to guide me along the way. And then she said, you know what, sis, your cough is not good, so you better go to the emergency room. So I went to the emergency room. I had tests, x-ray, I had my RT-PCR. I had my, that's the reason why I posted on my IG, which has now lots of views, 1,000 of views now. I had an ABG, and then the news came up, the doctor told me that I need to be admitted. But you know what my thinking is, I really would want to go home to take care of the kids still because they have the medications to drink. I need to cook, I need to take care of them. And it's really like a hard decision to me because I know that I need my body to rest, but I'm thinking of my family still, and it's not really easy. But I'm praying na sooner I could get better. Taking medications at home, not going to be admitted. So I stayed here. I don't have, I'm happy hearing their voices, but the door is closed. I'm just here, and it breaks my heart every time they tried to bag the door and wanted to go here inside. So we had the food delivered na lang so that I could not cook for certain days. And it's really like the saddest part because I've been negative for two times and now I'm positive. You know, I don't know. I tried to really be strong, you know, praying until every night and until now because it's my day 5. It's hoping to be okay to return to work as well. You know, but it's hard, really hard. So I know maybe a lot of people is having the same scenario. So, you know, let's just pray. You know, I've listened to A Hope and Healing. Maybe I could share the vlog that I was listening to help you guys whenever you are feeling not okay right now. That may help you and strengthen your faith. And maybe this God's trying to tell me to rest. You know. And yeah, both my lungs that time have crackles. And yeah, they said I need to be admitted. But I opted because nga, I need to, you know. And I decided to do this vlog because I saw the result already and it's really positive. So I just don't wanna lose hope, you know, and keep on fighting. And maybe this is a blessing, you know. Blessing in some ways to rest. I don't know. But yeah, just a piece of advice, guys, you know, all the precautions that is needed, the protocols that you need to remember every time. The DOH is not, you know, being tired of saying us, please do it. And it's really not a hard or an easy, it's hard battle, you know. I thought that when you are in the hospital, it's really a battlefield. But when you have the COVID-19, it's much more worse than you were thinking. And I'm lucky that even I had this episode, maybe my faith strengthens me to be not be admitted. And the first day that I drank the medication on the 13th, I feel okay. Maybe because of my faith and the Lord helped me. But you know, each day passed, like until now, like I really having a problem of sleeping. But please pray for me. I'll be doing the same thing on those who are people experiencing this also. I don't want to make this vlog so long, but guys, please pray for me and I'll be praying for your families as well. Who's just comment down below if you have this kind of situation. I will be praying for you, for your families. And yeah, so okay, according to the DOH, so that we will be ending my story so that you could get my home isolation. And now let's go on the facts, my chinguuuus, about Omicron. So Omicron symptoms is a flu-like symptom. So it's very like different because it stays on the upper airway, they say. And I felt it also. So the symptoms is like heavy fever as well, you know that there's like that's the commonly for COVID, and headache, general body pain, like my husband experienced, cough and fatigue. So that's what Omicron symptoms. And our ENT consultant told me prior that I had this, be careful because itchiness of the throat is one of the symptoms and your voice changes. So that's the variant Omicron. While Delta, the symptoms is very severe and acute upper respiratory tract infection, of course, cough and coughs. It won't be, how do you say this, eliminated, because it's really like cough, colds, fever when it's COVID, because it's like a viral, you know, it's a viral, it's a flu-like symptom. So the difference of that, Delta has loss of taste and loss of smell, which is Omicron don't have. Okay, so don't be confused. And there's difficult breathing, shortness of breathing, and diarrhea. But you know what, guys, I experienced both. I don't, my voice changes, and there are times, like, on the 13th, I cannot smell or taste anything. So, I don't know, guys. So, just, you know, I don't know if both of the virus came to me. I don't know. Right? Because I'm really tired, and I don't have enough rest and sleep. So, according to DOH, if you're fully vaccinated, you may undergo a 7-day quarantine period. If you're not having any symptoms, or we call it asymptomatic. But RT-PCR may be done earlier, not be done earlier, the fifth day of exposure. Why? Because it will give you a negative result. And if you're a high risk exposure to COVID-19 cases, if you're asymptomatic, like I said, it's or fully vaccinated, it's only 7 days. If you are asymptomatic and unvaccinated, guys, sorry, you still need a 14-day quarantine at home. If you're asymptomatic and you know, unvaccinated, it's 14 days, guys. Always remember that. And if you're symptomatic, meaning you have symptoms on you and you're vaccinated and with negative RT-PCR, it's only 10 days. But on my case, I'm positive. I don't know. I will check my IDS nurse, or nurse in charge, for how many days. And if you're symptomatic and unvaccinated, you'll be 14 days quarantine, guys. So I'm really hoping that my vlog really helped you guys. But I know if your RT-PCR is positive, it's another days, it's 10 days, regardless of your vaccinated status or not. So I'm praying, guys, that you'll be okay, your family will be okay, and I hope this vlog helped you. And chinguuuuu, thank you for listening or for watching my vlog. And please, if you haven't been following or subscribing on my channel, please subscribe for health updates and other vlogs of health and things in life. Thank you very much. Goodbye, chingu. Things come through raindrops. What if your healing comes through tears? What if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes to know you're near? What if trials of this life, all your mercies in the sky?